Calculating the magnitude of a vector. You will find this on page 578 in the Namibian Ordinary Level Mathematics textbook, Y equals mx plus c to 6s. Calculating the magnitude of a vector. We use Pythagoras' theorem to calculate the magnitude of a vector. So if OM, x is the horizontal distance, y is the vertical distance, then OM, indicating magnitude with the vertical bars, it will be x squared plus y squared. Can you remember Pythagoras' theorem? So it will actually be OM squared is x squared plus y squared. But then to get rid of that square, we take the square root, and that's in giving me then this, and this is the magnitude, so x squared plus y squared. It's taking the square root on both sides. So in this example, if LM is 3 and negative 2, then the magnitude will be 3 squared plus negative 2 squared, which is 9 plus 4, which is the square root of 13. Okay, let's look at example 17. Express each of the vectors in the diagram as column vectors. So, if I look at the first one, so let's just count 1, 2, 3, 4, so that's negative 4 and up, 1, 2, 3, that's 3. If I look at CD, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's negative 5 and 0. So, the next one, number B, that was the column vectors. So, number B, find the magnitude of the vectors. So, AB, I just take the square. And the square of this one, so this will be 16 plus 9, and that will be the square root of 25, and that will be 5. And if I look at CD, I'm taking the square plus the square, so that will be 25, and the square root of 25 is 5. And then the last question, are the vectors equal? Now their size, their length are equal, but they are not equal vectors, because their directions is different. This is in this direction and this is in this direction. And we said in previous videos that if vectors are equal only if their magnitude and their direction will be equal. Okay, stop the video and do try now 17. You can continue the video as soon as you are finished. Okay, let's start. Express each of the vectors in the diagram as column vectors. Okay, so let's start. This is number A. So if I look at the first one, this is A. So if I write down the vector, this is 2 and 3. Okay, let's look at number B. I'm just going to change colors every time. And if I look at B, this is going to be negative 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and negative 5. Negative 2 and negative 5. And this is number C, and this is going to be negative 2 and negative 3. And then I'm going to look at number D. Number D, this is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's negative 4 and positive 1. And then number E, let's select blue again. And number E is going to be negative 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so negative 2 and negative 5. And then number E, F, that is going to be 2 and 3, positive both. And then number G, let's just check, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 4, and 1. And then number K, And what is number k going to be? It's going to be 3 and negative 1. And then m? Let's just see what would color m. And if I look at m, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 5, and positive 1. And the number n, and number n is going to be negative 2 and negative 3. Okay. And now what I'm going to do is find the magnitude of this vector. Okay, this is quite a lot, so let's just start here. So if I'm going to look at number A, I think we're going to use the same color. A was blue, so if I look at A, it's just going to be 2 squared plus 3 squared, and that is going to be 4 plus 9, which is going to be the square root of 13. We can leave it like this. And then if I look at number B, it's going to be negative 2 squared plus negative 5 squared, and that is going to be 4 plus 25, and that's going to be the square root of 29. And then number C, and number C is going to be negative 2 squared plus negative 3 squared, and that is going to be 4 plus 9, which is going to be the square root of 13. And then number D, and that's going to be negative 4 squared plus 1 squared, and that is going to be 16 plus 1, which is going to be the square root of 17. And then D, and then number E, and that is going to be negative 2 squared plus negative 5 squared, and that is going to be 4 plus 25, which is going to be the square root of 29. Okay, and then, okay, we are at E, then number F. And that is going to be 2 squared plus 3 squared, and that's going to be 4 plus 9, which is going to be the square root of 13. F, and then it's number G. And that's going to be negative 4 squared plus 1 squared, and that's going to be 16 plus 1, which is going to be the square root of 17. Let's move it to that side. G, and then number K, magnitude, and that is going to be 3 squared plus negative 1 squared, and that's going to be 9 plus 1. I just want to make that smaller. And that is going to be the square root of 10. Okay, moving it up a little bit. Okay, and then M, it's going to be negative 5 squared plus 1 squared, and that's going to be 25 plus 1, and it's the square root of 26. M, and then the last one, N, which is going to be negative 2 squared plus negative 3 squared, which is going to be 4 plus 9, which is going to be the square root of 13. And then the last one. Write down the equal vectors. Now we have to look at the sketch, but we can compare the square root of 13. Okay, so we can compare this two. There's a square root 13, there's a square root 13, and there is a square root 13. Okay, so we can look at A. Just look. We can look at A. We can look at C. We can look at F. And we can look at N. So if I look at this two, so this two will not be equal. But look at this two. They can be equal. Okay? And this two can be equal. So it's A and F. So A equals F. And if I look at C, will be equal to N. And C is equal to N. But they are not all equal. Only this two and this two, because the magnitude as well as the direction must be equal. Okay, so we can see this, the directions are equal. This, the directions are equal. And then let's just see if there's another one. So let's look at the 29. Only look at this two, so it's B and E. So B and E. I think this one is also correct. So we can also say, because the directions are equal, so B is equal to E. Oh, that equal sign's not nice. B is equal to E. Okay, because that was the 29s. Okay, let's look if I see another one. Or let's take a blue one. 17. Okay, let's look at the 17 and the 17. So it will be D and G. D and G. This look also equal. So, and D is equal to G. Okay, that's also equal. Let's just see if I count, and then the 26. There was not another 26, that was only. So that will be all the equal. Remember, the magnitude as well as the direction. Can you see the magnitudes are equal, but also the direction?